Yes, let's go, let's go. If you're like me, you love sports. You like streaming your favorite sports team or watching that movie that you were not able to watch live, and you got internet just for that. But then it sucks when something happens and your internet freezes. Okay, so to fix everything and make it simple, I went out and I bought the Linksys Velop home Wi-Fi system. These three things that you see right here are called nodes, and these are basically like modems spread throughout the house, just like you see here on the back of the box. I put one upstairs in the bedroom, one in the living room, one downstairs by the office. I even downloaded the app, and that gives me full control of all three. I can control everything and monitor it just how I want to monitor it. I put my first node here, right next to the routers. I also can run an Ethernet from that if I have an adapter to go to my laptop. The second node I put out in the living room so you can see it. And what I did is I connected this to the wall, and then I put the Ethernet cable in the back, essentially giving me a hardwired connection to my TV instead of having to use the Wi-Fi. The next one I put upstairs in the bedroom. Being that my phone and my laptop sometimes are on Wi-Fi, the hard connection from the Ethernet gives me full service from my actual service provider that I'm paying for. These things are just something that have totally changed the dynamics of my Wi-Fi throughout the house. Now before, I had an AC 1900 cable modem router combo. Basically what that meant is I had one modem that had a built-in router into it that I sat here by my office. Now that router had to connect all the devices in the living room, all the devices upstairs. Then I said, you know what, I'm gonna separate it. I went out and I got the standalone modem, connected this, and then as you saw, I got the nodes all around the house. The big benefit for me is this is a tri-band system. Basically what that means is you have three lanes of internet usage that you can block off so they don't get congested by everyone jumping on the same thing. One of those lanes is a 2.4 gigahertz, and then it has two separate lanes of 5 gigahertz. Now, when I'm utilizing this as the Ethernet, what it does is, being that it's plugged into the wall outlet actually turns into a modem system inside my house, allowing the places where I put those nodes to have Ethernet connection as if it's a standalone modem. So now when I have the TV in the living room plugged up to the Ethernet, I have had zero buffering since I've added this system to that. Since I did the same thing upstairs in the master bedroom, I have the Ethernet connected to the other node, seamless streaming either if I'm watching my sports or watching movies or TV shows. Now, if we want to talk about cons, there is a con because price-wise, this is not friendly. Just for this system alone, for the three nodes that I bought, this was running around $350. Now, when I went out and got the standalone modem, I decided to go from the 3.0 DOCSIS to the 3.1 DOCSIS. Now, in case you don't know what that means, if you don't have 3.1 DOCSIS, that means that you cannot get a gigabyte download speed or upload speed. So I just wanted to be prepared in case I get ready for the upgrade. So with that, I went up from $179 and $350, and I spent probably around $550 for everything. So that's probably going to be a big con for a lot of people. So now that my cable's back up and running, I'm gonna put a description below for this particular system and the modem so you can check it out for yourself or see what else might be suitable for your needs. Again, while you're down there, like I always say, hit that subscribe button and tell a friend. Also, follow me on Facebook at OnTheWire and follow me on Twitter and Instagram at TheRealOnTheWire so you guys can see a side of me that you don't see while I'm doing these reviews. I hope you enjoyed the video. This has been another production from OnTheWire. I'm out.